That's video of Austin, Texas police officers pulling a woman out of a car. A bystander also took these still pictures of the event. He thought the police were abusing the woman. So who's right? Who is David and who is Goliath in that situation? Did the police abuse that woman? Or did the man who confronted the police abuse underpaid civil servants who risked their lives trying to keep us safe? With police officers being shot, it's not always clear who's David and who's Goliath, but Antonio Beeler says it's clear to him he was the bystander in that video, and you say there's no question the police are Goliath.
Yeah, they can commit crimes, they can kill people, and they can get away with it.
Well, commit crimes, they can't get away with that.
Well, they have in my case. They abused a woman who had not committed any crime. They ended up arresting her.
Well, it was a DUI arrest.
But she was a passenger. She had not committed any crime. She was not suspected of committing a crime. And they pulled her out of the vehicle. They abused her. And then I tried to ask questions and take pictures. So they came up to me, got on my face, started pushing and shoving me. And they falsely charged me with a felony crime that I did not commit.
And this is where I think your argument is best, that our best protection against the people we empower to imprison us is the camera. And it's legal everywhere in America to photograph the police doing their jobs. But lots of people get arrested for that. And the cops who do it, to my knowledge, never get punished. I mean, in your case, the Austin police said, "You spat on me. You're resisting arrest."
Well, that's right. And even though we had numerous witnesses step forward to say that that was a lie, and we had audio and video, they continued to push my charges against me. It took 15 months for it to go to a grand jury, at which time they indicted me on 4 new charges.
And 2 years, finally, you got a jury trial, and jury said, let him go.
Well, it was actually 2 years and 9 months before we finally took it to trial, and it took them that long to actually give us the dash cameras. But yeah, I was found not guilty, but...
And one of the Austin cops testified for you, actually.
That's right. He crossed the thin blue line, and he was then fired once he told his commanders that he was going to testify.
You now call yourself a police accountability activist.
I do that on the side. My main job is education, but yes, I'm a police.
You've been arrested a bunch of times.
I've been arrested,
taking pictures.
Yeah, I've been arrested 5 times, and every single time I was trying to film the police
to defend the police. They go onto these situations, and often they are scared. They don't know who's in the car, if they're armed. Some people hate the police. Cops have been killed. They're being nervous and careful.
Well, cops have a relatively safe job. It's safer than pilots, construction workers, sanitation workers.
Yeah, I think we have a chart on this, and this is remarkable because they often say we should get paid more because our job is much more dangerous, but it's much less dangerous than fishing or farming or being a roofer or garbage man.
And, you know, every life that is lost is tragic. But police officers, like soldiers, actually volunteered for jobs that carry the risk of violence. The people they abused never volunteered for that.
They do, though, go into the situation scared. The fisherman and the logger don't. There is an extra element of fear in police work.
Well, I think a lot of that fear is self-generated. They continually tell themselves that they're victims, that they're the ones who are being targeted.
You say there's certain things the public should know when dealing with a police officer.
By filming the police, you can help save a life. You can provide that evidence which will help exonerate an innocent person. And the act of filming police actually changed the behavior of the police to where they are more likely to respect the dignity of the people that they're interacting with.
You have to be careful not to interfere with the arrest, but if you keep your distance, you have every right to take pictures.
Yeah, and the distance is, it depends on the situation. When we film police in highly crowded areas downtown, you know, we'll get as close as 15, 10 feet to them, but there's people who are walking within a couple feet of them, but they don't ever seem to be concerned or scared of the random passerbyer. They only tend to be scared of the people with cameras.
You have a right to film the police. Thank you, Antonio. Coming up, how libertarians are mocked by Goliaths like Bill O'Reilly.